I accepted the role of Dancing with the St. Louis Stars in part because I was pressured by my boss. No, that's not really true. But I was encouraged by my boss, who's a former dancer. That's Warner Baxter, the president of and CEO of Ameren Corporation. I have no prior experience with dancing. I believe my mom tried to get me to tap dance when I was 4, and I didn't like it and threw the shoes away. So no experience with dancing, unless you count wedding dancing, but that usually has some alcohol that encourages the dancing. So no experience with dancing. Well, Michael and I have only had one lesson together so far, so I'm still new to this. I'm very nervous. I'm the kind of person who, I'm an engineer by background, so I'm very logical and methodical. And so I'm trying to remember everything he's telling me and do it all at the same time and do it perfectly, but that exactly doesn't work. So I think I need to learn to relax a little.
So some of the qualities that I've seen in Maureen and our one lesson that we've had is that she is driven and dedicated to do it well, which is a huge advantage.
Well, obviously being a part of this event is a little intimidating because you are going to be in front of a large group of people doing something out of your comfort zone, which is, you know, different for me, challenging for me. So I know everyone is competing for votes, and my strategy is to tap my construction vendors. I run a big construction company. I figure that, you know, I've done a lot for them over the years. They've certainly helped us be successful. Now I need them to help me be successful in fundraising for the great work that the Independence Center does.
I think we have an advantage in gaining audience support because we have a very energetic routine.
And hopefully that's going to get the audience all, you know, jazzed up, and they'll forget about my footwork mistakes, and the judges will get excited by the audience, and we'll get more votes that way,
yeah,
right?
There you go.
I think my involvement in the event, particularly my tour of the Independence Center, has led me to understand that mental illness is an illness, but it's something that can be overcome, and that people, if given the right skills, if given the right support, can function independently and live a really high quality of life. What I would like to share with the audience is, first of all, be kind, and second of all, have fun. So, and be generous.
Please welcome couple number 6, Maureen Borkowski and Michael Fitzgerald. Job. What's it like dancing, you know, in front of about 700 people?
Well, I didn't fall, and I didn't have a wardrobe malfunction, so I consider that success.
Yeah, that's a double win right there. What has this whole experience been like for you, Maureen?
It's really been exciting. I have to thank Michael. He's been just a saint. Yeah. So patient, but also so funny. I mean, you know, to be humorous when I'm kind of intense, and it's just been wonderful. And of course, when you know it's for such a great cause, it's worth all the effort and the, you know, the having to humble yourself at recognizing your limitations. But it's been great.
Michael, what was the inspiration for the routine that you guys had here tonight?
Maureen said she wanted something fast.
And that worked.
I didn't realize it would be that fast.
From day one to your last dance lesson, talk about the progression that this lady had.
From He's speechless.
From the very beginning all the way to the end.
The entire time was just very detail-oriented with her, constantly asking me questions about, okay, what do I do here? Where is this step right? Is that step right? Okay, I know I screwed this up. Where do I get? How do I fix this? What do we do here?
Yeah. A good time overall, though.
Oh, right? Yeah, definitely.
So you were politely nudged into this by some individuals
Warner
who are
Baxter.
Here
there
tonight.
He is.
Yeah, he's waving.
He strongly encouraged me, but once I agreed and had the opportunity to visit the Independence Center, it absolutely grabs your heart, and it just absolutely reinforced that this is the right thing to do. And so forever grateful to all the folks here and all the people that have voted for supporting the great work they do.
Yeah, both of you did a wonderful job tonight.